Hello students, good morning. I am Prem Gupta, your English teacher. Dear students, in the previous classes we were discussing the chapter number 2, that is noun, the number, in which we were discussing the very important topic, that is singular and plural number. Dear students, I have already told you what is singular number and what is plural number, and we have also discussed rule number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Today we will discuss the rule number 5. But before starting the rule number 5, I would like to revise the previous things which you have read. Dear students, first of all, you should know that what is singular number. I hope that you all know, but once again I am telling you. Dear students, singular numbers are those which denotes only one person or one thing. That is known as a singular number. Okay? And what is plural number? Plural numbers are those, the noun which denotes more than one person or one thing. That is known as plural number. Dear students, I have also told you so many rules. Rule number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Today we will discuss the 5, but I will also revise the rule number 1. In the rule number 1, I have told you that is very simple. We add only S for making plural. In the singular number, we add only S for making plural. For example, we can see here, example, bag. That is singular. And for making plural, we will add only S here. Okay, students, this is the rule first. And what is the rule second? Rule second, in which I have told you we will add ES. But there is a condition when the singular number ends with S, double S, S, double S, SH, CH, and X. Okay, I have told you that we add ES into the singular number for making plural if the singular number ends with these words S, double S, SH, CH and X. For example, I have told you S. What would be the S? Bus. Okay. Bus is there. We will make here buses. Okay. For example, double S. What would be the correct word? Class. There is double S. And we will add here ES. Okay. In the same way, suppose that there is box. We will add here ES. Okay, students, this is the second rule. In the second rule, we will add ES if the singular noun ends with S, double S, SH, CH and X. Okay, students, and third rule. In the third rule, I have told you, at the place of Y. In the third rule, third A, there are two rules I have told you. In the third A, I have told you, if any singular noun that ends with Y, And before Y, if there is vowel, then we will change it into IES at the place of Y. We will write IES. For example, we can see here, baby, B-A-B-Y. Okay, we can see here, it ends with Y, and before Y, there is a consonant. Okay, students, here there will be consonant. And before Y, if there is consonant, then we will add here IES. B-A-B-I-E-S. Okay, that is the third A rule. Okay, and what is the third B? And here before Y, if there is vowel. Before Y, if there is vowel, then we will add only S into the singular noun.
okay? For example, we can see here twice, okay? It ends with y, but before y, what is there? That is vowel. Therefore, we will add here only s. Okay, students, this is the rule number third. And in the rule number fourth, I have told you, if any singular noun that ends with f or fe, okay, then at the place of f or fe, we will change it es. Okay, for example, you can say here thief, thief. That is singular, and it also ends with the f. Then we will change at the place of f, we will write what? Ves. Then it would be thieves, thieves. Okay, students, for example, one more you can see, that is life. It ends with fe, and at the place of fe, what do we write? Li, we will write ves. Okay, lives. Okay, students, so we have read in the previous classes rule number first, in which you have to only add s, and second rule, that is we will add es, but there is a condition, the singular number noun ends with the s, ss, sh, ch and x. Okay, and in the third a rule says that if before y there is a consonant, then we will add here ies at the place of y. And if before y, if there is vowel, then we will add only s into the singular number. And rule fourth says that at the place of f and fe, we will use ves. Okay, for example, we can see here, okay, thief, thieves, life, life. Now today we will discuss the rule number 5. Everyone open the notebook. Your student, open the notebook. Today we will discuss the rule number 5. That is very simple also. And I hope that you all have understand the rule first, second, third and fourth. And come to the rule number 5. Rule 5. Okay? Just put the heading and write down. What is rule number 5? Some singular nouns can be, just write down, some singular noun can be, some singular noun can be changed into, can be changed into plural nouns into plural nouns when by adding their, by changing their internal vowel, internal vowel. Okay, students, just write down this. Okay, rule number 5 says that some singular nouns can be changed into plural nouns by changing their internal vowels. Okay, students, we will see the examples. Example, we will see here. Then we can understand very easily. Okay. Internal vowel. Mouse. M-O-U-S-E. What is the internal vowel? Dear students, we all know that what is vowel? A-E-I-O-U. These are vowels. Okay. And what is the vowel in this word? Internal vowel. That is O and U. And while making plural, we will change this vowel and we will write M-I-C-E. Okay? The plural of mouse is mice. Okay, students?
Just keep in your mind, sometimes we make plural by changing their internal vowels. Okay? Mouse, mice. Now, once again, foot, there are two vowels. There is vowel O, double O, and we will change it into feet. Okay, that is the internal vowel O, double O, and we have changed it. And here OU, we have changed it into I. Okay, one more example you can see, goose. It will be changed into geese. Okay, there are vowels and this is also vowel. Okay, man. What is vowel in this? That is vowel, A is vowel, and for making plural we will add here only E. Okay students, so you have to learn it and also keep in your mind that sometimes we make plural by changing the internal vowels. Okay, we can see the example, mouse, OU, I have changed it into I. The plural of mouse is mice. Okay, foot, feet, goose, geese, man, men, woman, women. Okay, in this way you will change. Okay students, just write down the rule number 5, that is very simple. I hope that you all have understand this rule, rule number 5. And there are some important things that you have to keep in your mind. There are so many singular number, there are so many nouns that is used as a singular number as well as plural number both. There is no difference in singular and plural both. Now we will discuss that. Okay, just keep in your mind all the things which I am teaching. Okay student, you put the heading note, that is very very important. Okay, you put the heading note, N-O-T-E, and in which you will write the words which are used as a singular, as a plural. Okay, same. Now see, some nouns have, just write down here, some nouns have the same form in both numbers, singular and plural. Okay, singular and plural. Okay, we can see the examples. Example, we will see example. What are they? Cattles. Cattles, we can see here. Cattle. C-A-T-T-L-E. Okay? Cattle is used as a singular and plural both. Okay? There is no plural of this. The word cattle is used as a singular as well as plural both. And series. Series. And it is also used as a singular and plural both. Sheep. Sheep. And that is also used as a singular and plural both. There is no difference in singular and plural with this word. See, okay, here, H-A-I-R, fish, deer, news, furniture, okay students, scenery,
there are so many words that we use as a singular as well as a plural. Okay, there is no difference in singular and plural. Cattle is used as a singular and plural both. Series is also used as a singular and plural both. Sheep, hare, fish, deer, news, furniture, sceneries, and there are so many other words that are used as a singular and as a plural both. Okay, you have to learn it that there is no plural of it. Okay, so in this way we have completed the rules for changing from singular to plural. Okay students, now we will discuss the exercises given in your book. Just open the book now. Dear students, this is your book, Grammar Act, and just open the book, chapter number 2 and the exercise number 1. Okay? Dear students, in this chapter, in chapter number 2, the noun, the naming words, we have read the definition of noun, kinds of noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. And we have also read singular and plural number. Okay? There are two numbers, that is singular and plural. And we have also read there are so many rules for changing from singular to plural. And rule number 1st, rule number 2nd, rule number 3rd, 4 and 5. And there are some special notes are also there. We have to keep in your mind. We have to keep in our mind all these words so that we could not commit any kind of mistake in future. Okay students, now just open the book, page number 10. Page number 10, exercise number 1st we will discuss today. Okay, just open. I'm going to erase it. Okay, dear student, put out the pencil also. The question is filling the blanks with countable noun. Dear students, we have to fill the blanks, okay, with countable noun, with countable noun, countable nouns and uncountable noun, countable and uncountable. We have to fill in the blanks countable and uncountable noun as indicated within the brackets. Follow the examples. One example is already given, and here in the bracket written that what you have to fill, countable or uncountable. Okay students, so first question we will see here. Just see the first question. The marketplace was surrounded by the, and in the bracket written countable nouns. Okay, countable nouns, first of all you have to know that what is countable noun. Dear students, I have already told you what is countable. The noun which can be counted, that is known as countable noun. And the noun which cannot be counted, that is known as uncountable noun. Okay students, I have told you proper, common, collective are countable noun, and material and abstract nouns are uncountable noun. Okay students, and now just see, the marketplace was surrounded by the countable noun you have to fill. What would be the correct answer? People, surrounded by the people, P-E-O-P-L-E. We can count the people. Yes, why not? We can count the people, and here you have to fill the countable noun. Okay students, the marketplace was crowded by the people. So in the first blank you fill the word people. Okay student, you will fill the blanks with the help of pencil only. You will not use the pen while writing in the book. Okay, come to the question number 2nd. What is the question number 2nd? The dot 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 liked the movie very much. You have to fill here countable noun. Okay, the student, you can fill here the students. Students, okay,
you will feel your students like the movie very much. And you have to fill your countable noun. And student is what? Student is countable noun. You can count the number of students. You can count the number of people. Okay, students? So in the first blank, you will fill the word people. In the second blank, you will fill the word student. Okay, turn the page, page number 11. Question number 3. Here, there are two blanks. And in the first blanks, you have to fill the uncountable noun. And in the second blank, you have to fill the countable noun. What is the question? Question number 3. I am going to write the sentence where there is a blank, okay, and there is also blank. Okay, students, now see. Here, in the first blank, you have to fill the uncountable noun. Uncountable, that means that you cannot count. And in the second blank, you have to fill the countable noun. Here, students, I have told you what are uncountable nouns. Material and abstract nouns are known as uncountable noun. And that we cannot count. So, here, where there is a will. Will means desire, ichha. Okay, will is what? Abstract noun. Will is abstract noun. That is uncountable. We cannot count the will or willpower. Okay, where there is will, there is a way. Okay, we can count the way. Okay, so that is the correct answer. Where there is will, there is a way. And that is uncountable noun and the way. Way is countable noun. Okay, students, just fill it. That is the correct answer. Question number 4. Here, students, the blank is given here. Question number 4. Blank is given. Is the capital of India? Is the capital of India? Dear students, in this question, there is a mistake in the book that you have to, here the question is written, what uncountable noun? You have to fill here uncountable noun, uncountable. You have to fill here uncountable noun. Okay, just see here. Dear students, it is very simple, Delhi, okay? You can also fill the New Delhi. Delhi is the capital of India. Delhi is the capital of India. But students, in the question it is written uncountable. But the Delhi is countable. Dear student, the question is wrong. So you cut the word un. Okay, you cut the word in your book un. Because Delhi is a state, we can count. It denotes a number. That is a state. Therefore, that is countable noun. We can count. That is a one state. Okay? Delhi is the capital of India. In the question, it is written uncountable. That is not possible. Therefore, you cut the word un. UN. In the same way, in the question number 5 also it is given. Question number 5 is given. What is the question? The is written already here. Okay? And there is a blank, and is the largest ocean, and here you have to fill in the question given uncountable noun. That is wrong. Okay, in your book it is written to fill here uncountable noun. That is not possible. Okay? Pacific Ocean. Okay? That is the largest ocean. That is the largest ocean and that we count.
Okay, that is proper noun that we count, and therefore you again cut the word un in the question and fill the blanks with these word Pacific Ocean. Okay student, this is the correct answer. In the first blank you will fill the people, that is countable noun, students. In the second blank you will fill the students, that is countable noun. In the third blank, okay, there are two blanks in the question number third. In the first blanks you will fill the uncountable noun will, and another is way, the word way, that is countable noun. And in the question number four you have to fill the Delhi, and that is countable noun, although it is written in your book uncountable, that is wrong, you cut the word un. And in the question number five it is also written uncountable, but the correct answer will be Pacific Ocean, and that can be counted, therefore you will cut the word un in your book. Okay students, so this is all about the exercise first. So dear students, today I have completed the exercise first, and we have also completed the rules for changing from singular to plural. Okay student, this is all for today. Thank you.